Okay, so now we're going to focus on what we're going to call the graphs of functions. So in this problem, we're asked to graph f of x equals 3x minus 2. So first of all, whenever you see f of x can always be replaced with y. So I can literally just write y is equal to 3x minus 2. Okay? And once you do that, you can see in this case that this is the graph of a line. And I can see that the slope m is equal to 3, which I can think of as 3 over 1. And b, the y-intercept is negative 2. So graphing this line, well, b is negative 2, there's my y-intercept. And I'm going to use the slope, right? I'm going to rise 3 and run 1. So up 1, 2, 3, and running 1 brings me to a second point right there for my line. And now I'm going to draw a line through those two points. Okay, so this would be the graph of that function. So what's important to notice is that whenever you have f of x, you can always replace that whole thing with a y and then graph whatever equation you have. Okay, let's take another one like that. Okay, let's graph this function f of x equals the absolute value of x take away 2. So I'm not quite sure what this looks like yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a chart. And the chart is going to look like this, x, and then next to that in the chart, I'm going to have f of x. Now remember, f of x is the corresponding y. Okay, so this is a graph or a table of having x and y. So if I pick some values for x, like negative 2 and negative 1, 0, 1, and 2, for each of these values of x, there's a corresponding y. And to find that, you use this relationship. So for example, if x is negative 2, what's my corresponding y? Let's go ahead and do that here. So f of negative 2, right? Because that's what you do with the x. You plug it in right there and right there. So this is going to be the absolute value of negative 2 minus 2. And the absolute value of negative 2 is 2, take away 2, which is equal to 0. Okay, so f of negative 2 is equal to 0. And that's why I put a 0 right here. So when x is negative 2, y is 0. And now what if x is negative 1? Let's do that one in our head here. The absolute value of negative 1 is 1, and 1 take away 2 is negative 1. If I plug in 0, I'm going to get negative 2. If I plug in 1, I'm going to get negative 1 again. And if I plug in 2, I'm going to get 0 again. So let's plot these ordered pairs. I have 5 of them. X is negative 2, y is 0, x is negative 1, f of negative 1, or y, is also negative 1. X is 0, y is negative 2. X is 1, y is negative 1. And x is 2, y is 0 right here. Okay, now we'll go ahead and draw a graph through these points. And there we go. So this is the example of what's called an absolute value function. This is pretty common. You'll see this again. Absolute value function. And just for fun, we can also state what the domain and the range is of this function. So the domain, as we learned from previous videos. Well, when you think about the domain, you want to think about the x-axis. And we like to think of this as a thermometer, so it can go all the way to negative infinity and in that direction, and the thermometer going in this direction all the way to positive infinity. So the domain is negative infinity to positive infinity. And the range, now we refer to this thermometer, right? So what's the lowest temperature? Well, negative 2 is the low temperature. And what's the high temperature? Well, there is no highest temperature, right? The temperature goes all the way up. There's no upper bound, as I can see from the graph. The graph keeps going up. So we'd write infinity in that case, indicating there's no highest temperature. Okay, let's try another one relating another example relating to the graphs of functions. Okay, let's find all the values of x for which s at x is 3, and this is the graph of s here. So remember what we said earlier, that whenever you see f of x or g of x or s of x, right, this means y. So you're looking at y is equal to 3. And the question is asking you to find all values of x for which y is 3. So what I do is I go on the y-axis, right, on this axis, and I say, okay, when is y 3? All along here. So I mentally move my eye along here like this. And I said, oh, when is y 3? And I see, right, there would be one point, right? Do you see the x corresponding to that value of 3? It would be on the x-axis. It would be down here. So one value would be x is equal to 1. And there's a second value is right. So you can see that, you know, if y is 3, you keep going over like this. Y is 3 twice in this case, right? Y is 3 right here as well. And what's the value of x? You bring it down, and I'd say maybe x is equal to 4. So both when x is 1 and x is 4, y is 3. And this would be our answer to that question. And likewise, for this problem, we can also talk about the domain and the range, even though we weren't asked to do this. Might be kind of fun for us again. The domain, well, the function, you know, along the x-axis, the temperature can drop down to negative 2, and it goes all the way up to 5. So the domain is going to be negative 2 to 5. And the range of this function, now we're thinking about the thermometer along the y-axis. The temperature can go all the way down to 0, right? So the 0 is the lowest temperature on the y-axis. And all the way up, let's see, how high does it go? I'd say it goes to about 4 or so, right? It doesn't go any higher than 4. So the range is from 0 to 4. Okay, so this is how you work with the graphs of functions.